If you wonder why I'm wearing sunglasses, is my seeing glasses broke. And so I'm wearing these shades so you don't see me squinting. So this quote is a quote from my Gurudeva. I'm closer to you than the air you breathe. When you accept a guru, when you have a guru, he's more dear to you than the air that you breathe. A spiritual guru will explain to you the most important lesson that you have to learn. More than what your parents taught you, more than what your teachers taught you, more than what life even shows you. Guru, what he says is canon. You know, when you accept a spiritual master, he's giving you the most intimate knowledge of yourself. And when you use that knowledge to be for the betterment, your guru is not something you take lightly at all, you know? Because I never understood the guru trip, you know, when I first was getting involved in, Indian philosophy. I'd be impressed with their lectures. I would love what they were saying, you know, how they were interpreting the books from, you know, Srila Prabhupada, who was the real, you know, mind-blowing spiritual guru that came to America back then in the 60s. I just, you know, wasn't on that surrender tip, and I didn't understand surrender. I went a long time without surrendering or without accepting a guru until I had an experience. I had this spiritual experience where I saw God. I don't know how else to say it. You know, I didn't think it was possible to have these kind of experiences nowadays. Spiritual teachers will try to tell you is don't look for those magical experiences, because, you know, not that they don't come, but, you know, when you seek them, you could be misled. A lot of people are tricksters. And so they try to, you know, throw a little bit of hocus pocus in with their philosophy in order to blow your mind. Because there is no other knowledge as important as the knowledge that your spiritual master will give you. It's very, very important that you find your guru, right? And guru is one, you know. It's not just because I think the philosophy of one person touched you in a way, now that person's no longer on the earth, I think you're not going to accept anybody else as your guru. I've got to say that that's wrong. The guru is one. When you finally find that guru, he says the same thing, and he'll touch your heart that same way. He'll melt your heart. And when he melts your heart, he's closer to you than the air you breathe. Rely on him for everything, sanctifying your life, sanctifying your food, sanctifying your words, dovetailing all your material actions in accordance with what the guru tells you to do, and positive things will happen. I'll give you a quick example. You know, I saw my guru one time. I asked him what I needed to do. So I wanted to keep my dreads and my beard, and he looked at me and he went, "Cut it." At this picture, I'm asking him about my, you know, if I should keep my beard. He tells me to cut it. Well, I was shocked, you know, and I was like, oh my God, I guess I gotta cut it. My beard, so I can cut my beard. So he said, don't shave now, and don't take diksha, second initiation now. He goes, come to India and you can take Dharam Pribram, cut your beard, put it in the river, and make it very, you know, interesting. So I didn't cut my beard. I was all set to, reluctantly, but I kind of felt like I was talked out of it a little bit, so I accepted that. Tried as I may, there was no way I could make it to India. I had this streak of bad luck. When you start living, I started living a material life, and started forgetting my goals and what I needed to do. I started to become more involved in material life, falling down. I was more in the modes of passion, ignorance, than I was in the modes of goodness. So I said, I'm having all this bad luck because I didn't shave. I didn't do it like you told me. So I shaved. Shaved my head, shaved my beard. And miracles are true. This really, really happened. I get on the computer. All of a sudden, I get an email from somebody I haven't talked to in almost 2 years. And he says, Aldo, you still want to go to India, right? I want to open up a tattoo parlor in India. You tattoo. One thing led to another. Within a week, I was in India. One week after I shaved, I was in India. So I ended up going to India, and this was in 2011. And on top of that, I haven't shaved since 2011. I haven't shaved since that trip to India. And this is the result. But I'm all right. I'm going to shave again soon. I'm closer to you than the air you breathe. So I was in a motorcycle accident. And I was in a coma for 5 days. All I can remember, all I can testify to, that in that coma for 5 days, I remember sitting with my Guru Maharaj for like 10, 15 minutes, giving me his mercy, and me remembering I must be dead because I'm sitting with my Guru Maharaj, who passed last year from the material world. I have a daughter. Just becoming a teenager, and I need to be there for her. Please, 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 can I go back? He smiled, closed his eyes, and I woke up. Tubes in my throat, broken wrists, broken pelvis, external fixators, colostomy bags, urine bag. I'm hooked up like a robot. But I'm here, I survived. And I owe it all to my Gurudev's mercy. And of course, the doctors and everybody that helped, keep this meat puppet functioning so my soul can still perform its purpose. And that's what I feel is the real, when the guru finds you, when you find your guru, there's no separation. There's no, it's just you trying your best. And the Guru giving you his mercy. And eventually that mercy will come bear fruit. I dedicate my life to my Guru Maharaj. I try. I'm not perfect. The servant of the servant of the servant of the servant. There's no ego in serving in this way. It's like Bob Dylan said, you may serve the devil or you may serve the Lord, but you're going to serve somebody. Seek, your Guru with mindfulness. Don't be foolish, right? I was lucky because even though I wasn't ready to surrender, I got a sign from above, and there was no way nobody could have played this magical trick because I've never seen anything like that before. It's a difficult subject, and I'm going to talk more about gurus on my blog. Maharaj is closer to you. In this world, after the party, no difference. There's no difference. The only difference is your physical association, which you can still have association with through mercy, through a photograph, through thinking, Please leave any questions or comments, below. I'll try to answer them. And please forgive any offenses that I may have made. Through surrender to my Guru Maharaj, I've gained so much, and that I may sound a little cultish or something like that, but it really is. Until you surrender, you don't know. But please forgive any offenses that I made, because I know maybe a lot of you who are watching this also have no Guru Maharajas. Maybe went about it a little bit differently. Please share your experiences. Again, I mean no offense. It's all intentional. Thank you so much.